white trash riverboat Tom Sawyer. He tried to sue my voodoo lawyer. I held him up, bringing home his bacon, and I cooked it lean in the kitchen with Satan.
Messieurs, dames, bonjour et bienvenue à l'émission Cuisine. Cuisine.
Oui, bonjour. Comment allez-vous, madame, monsieur? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Nous allons préparer pour vous ce soir des plats exceptionnels.
Easy, just kidding. We're not really French.
No. Thank God.
Yeah, imagine that. A fate worse than leprosy.
Cut. Boys, can't be racist, can't be patronising, okay? Okay, back to position one.
Hi there, everyone. I think I'm Nick Piper.
And I'm sure I'm Joel Green.
But you're definitely watching Spoiling the Broth, the only show on TV that has a title which pretty much explains all.
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, people know what they're going to get by reading the title, Spoiling the Broth. It's pretty obvious what the show's about.
Spoiling the broth would be about cooking badly, maybe unintentionally, and the audience would watch us and learn from our mistakes. Oh yeah, hang on a sec. Speak for yourself.
Now what have you ever cooked?
I do soup.
You're a f***ing idiot.
And by the way, don't be so quick to cast judgment on me. I've eaten your fish and chips.
Where the hell is Nick with the food? I am starving.
Sorry I'm late, everyone. Made four portions.
You're a f***ing idiot.
Anyway, flashbacks aside, let's have a quick look at how the show is really played with our cooking referee, Mr. Ian Boyd.
Step one. Both Nick and Joe will be given separate recipes plus some basic instructions and a list of ingredients. Step two. The lads will then try and cook their dishes without any guidance. Step 3, the crew will then taste test each dish. Step 4, an expert chef will then choose a winner. And the loser will be punished.
So that's it really, we cook, the crew gets to eat, and you at home get to see who spoils the broth.
Before we start, let's have a quick gander at the kitchen we're in using breakthrough technology, the frying pan cam.
The modern Spoiling the Broth kitchen is fully equipped with all the necessary amenities. There's a fully functional stovetop with four elements, a gas oven, and a fridge bursting with a selection of delightful ingredients, including hummus, lettuce, and a sausage. While our hosts are busy in the kitchen, the cooking will be overseen by referee Ian Boyd. Any deep, throaty voiceovers will be performed by me, Dave Jeffrey.
We're about to embark on our food journey, and for that we need a gastronomical map, so it's about time we ask...
Recipes please!
Chicken fricasse, chicken fricasse. And yours?
Real English shepherd's pie.
So there we have it. The recipes are ready to be cooked. Join us after the break when the lads tackle the complexities of their dishes and hunt out their ingredients.
Who keeps saying that?
I think it's him.
Well, at least we don't have a laugh track.
We'll be right back after this.
Welcome back to Spoiling the Broth. We're here outside the Super Barn supermarket where we're just about to stock up on some ingredients. Now, my shopping list doesn't generally extend past baked beans and bread.
Yeah, nor mine, except maybe condoms now that I'm married. Anyway, for the benefit of you guys at home, the recipes will appear on screen when we get back into the kitchen. But until then,
Here's a list of our ingredients. Here's mine.
Here's mine.
Good luck.
I don't need luck. I just need help. Okay, well, apparently getting potatoes is not that easy. We got washed, Desiree, chats, kip fluff. Well, I don't want these because that means we're going to have to wash them.
My first ingredient is roux, R-O-U-X. I have absolutely no idea what that's short for. Maybe kangaroo.
Do you reckon that's about a kilo or what? Huh?
Are you in the middle of something? Look, just really quickly, what's roux?
Now, I do know something about onions, so I'm going to go with the Spanish. Because I like Spanish onions. How many of them do I have to get? One. Oh.
I think I'm just going to go for four. And like in true man style, I've got nothing to carry all this stuff in other than my arms.
Now, I guess that's a large carrot.
Would I buy parsley by itself? Now, that's the only way I can buy parsley, right?
Yeah.
Continental. What's the difference? It doesn't really matter, I guess.
500 grams of chopped tomatoes. Now, I don't know whether that means I have to get them and chop them.
Gravy.
3 tablespoons of tomato puree. Plain flour, potato flour, gluten-free flour, brown rice flour, no corn flour, spelt flour. Is spelt flour. 500 grams. It doesn't look as red as the other stuff. Oh, that's beef.
So I think season all is actually seasoning. Hey, here we go, look.
Done, happy days.
That's it, I actually thought it'd be a lot more. So let's fuck it all up and get out of here. Get everything?
Yep. And now, through the magic of television, we will literally jump back into the kitchen.
Oh, what a seamless transition that was.
Gold.
Well, hang on a minute. Weren't you on the...
No.
All right, boys, all right. Good luck today. You've got your recipes.
Mm-hmm.
You've got your ingredients. You're good to go.
Yep.
Just a reminder of the basic rules. No help from anyone. That includes mobile phones, hidden notes. And absolutely no drugs, because as we know, chefs don't use amphetamines, do they?
If you want Joel to snigger to himself, push the red button. If you want Nick to mutter, pigs might fly, push the blue button. Or if you want all three to raise their eyebrows in a comic manner to a chorus of sitcom laughter, push the green button. You chose option 3.
And the most important rule, no mocking and no teasing. Because we all remember what happened last time, don't we?
Make sure you cut it quite straight. Leave a lot of meat on the sides.
Okay lads, shake hands, let's get cooking.